A turboshaft engine acts as the powerhouse of modern helicopters. They are also used for power generation and marine propulsion. Turboshaft engines are primarily used on helicopters. The biggest difference between turboshafts and turbojets is that turboshaft engines use the majority of their power to turn a turbine, rather than produce thrust out the back of the engine. To produce the energy for the aircraft engine, the turboshaft uses the same principle which turbojet used to fly the aircraft, and the compressor will be incorporated. In turboshaft engines, air gets in the front, heats it up, and then compresses it, which then turns the shaft on the middle. That's why it is called as turboshaft engine. In a helicopter shaft, power produced by the turboshaft engine is used to run the rotor. The power shaft, which turns the rotor, receives power from a set of turbines. The turbine absorbs energy from hot and high pressure gas flowing over the blades. Airfoil technology enables the turbine blades to turn in order to properly guide the flow. A set of stator blades is used. These are fixed to the engine cover. The stator blades also ensure that sufficient flow velocity is maintained at the turbine row inlet. Now the question is how this high energy gas is produced. The answer is, a combustion chamber for effective combustion and atomized fuel form is to be mixed with medium temperature and high pressure air. This air is produced by a set of compression stages. You can see this compressor is fitted on a hollow shaft and is not connected to the power shaft. The compressor requires energy for its operation. This energy is provided by a new turbine set, which is fitted on the same hollow shaft. The only purpose of this new turbine is to supply energy to the compressor. It is referred to as a gas producer turbine. You can see how the gas producer turbine unit and power turbine unit rotate independently using a coaxial shaft arrangement. Thus, the synchronized operation of the compressor, combustion chamber, and turbine produce necessary power output. At the power shaft, a centrifugal compressor is also introduced in the compressor section to effectively compress the gas. These are the basic parts and workings of a turboshaft engine. Let's have a detailed look on the parts of a turboshaft engine. Air is compressed by one or more compressors. The axial compressor ensures a first stage of compression to supercharge the centrifugal compressor. A single-stage centrifugal compressor. The air flows radially from the center of the compressor to its perimeter. The power turbine extracts almost all the remaining energy in the gas flow to power the transmission system. Dual-stage power turbine rotates around 36,000 RPM. Single-stage centrifugal compressor rotates at 50,000 RPM. Centrifugal impeller is a single-entry impeller. The axial compressor is a four-stage axial flow compressor. A convergent air annulus is the entire compressor assembly and is located in this convergent duct. Combustion chamber is a reverse flow annular combustion chamber. The annular combustor consists of a single ring-shaped chamber between an inner and outer casing. Due to the continuity of the flow around the rings, flame propagation takes place with Mori's. The reverse flow combustor provides a larger combustion volume than would otherwise be obtained with a straight through flow combustion chamber. Thus, a potential gain in performance can be realized. Rotating shaft and by placing the fuel injectors in a readily accessible location. The primary purpose of the tail drive shaft is to transmit engine power to drive the rotary rudder. Reduction gearbox reduce the high rotational speed of the power turbine. Exhaust duct expels low energy gases away from the aircraft. The fuel nozzle is to atomize and vaporize the fuel for efficient combustion in the engine. Air inlet screen or filtration system is essential for the successful operation of a gas turbine. The filtration system protects the gas turbine from harmful debris in the ambient air. Accessory gearbox is used to extract power to drive components which are essential to the operation of the engine. Thanks for watching the video. For more videos, subscribe to my channel.